Hello and welcome to SciJoy. Today we're going to learn how to code incremental, quadrature, and absolute encoders.
Each encoder has its own objective or use. For the incremental encoder, the purpose is to count the number of rotations the motor has accomplished. We need to define some terms for our program. A rotation for our incremental encoder is accomplished every time 12 steps are counted. A step is recorded when the encoder transitions from one state to another. The unbroken state is a 1, which is a high, and the broken state is a 0, or a low. The algorithm is a checklist our program will complete. The program needs to know when the state changes occur, and to do this, we need to compare the current state to the previous one. We need to keep track of how many state changes have occurred. When we get 12 state changes, we need to increment the number of rotations that have been completed. We also need to reset the step count to 0 so it knows that we're at the start of a new rotation. We want to print all these values via the serial monitor so we can see what's happening. Now we can write the actual code. At the top, we define our global variables and constants. We need to define the digital pin that's going to be used by the signal wire of the breakbeam. For us, we're going to use pin 5, and this is a constant value in our code. And so is the number of steps in a rotation. We need a variable that keeps track of the current state of the sensor, the last state of the sensor, the number of steps, and the number of rotations. In our void setup, we need to start communications with a serial port. We will use 9600 for our baud rate, and the code needs to know that our sensor is a digital input pin. There's no pull-up resistor in our circuit, so we can turn on the Arduino's internal one. Inside the void loop, the first thing we need to do is look at the value of our sensor at that moment, and then we need to store it into the current state variable. If the current state is different from the last state that we read from the sensor, then we want to increment the number of steps. On the top line of the if statement, we use Boolean logic. This means we compare two values, and if the comparison is true, then we enter the if statement. If the comparison is false, then we move to the next step in our program. We're looking for a change in states. We don't want the values to be equal. We put an exclamation point in front of the equal sign, and this is a Boolean operator that means not. If they are not equal, then we know we have a state change, and we go inside the if statement, and we increment the step count by 1. When we are outside of the if statement, the last state has to be set to the current state. This will allow it to be compared to the new reading at the top of the next loop. Now we determine if there have been enough step changes to equal one rotation. If the number of track steps is 12, then we increment the count of rotations by 1. We also need to set the value of steps back to 0 so we can increment back up to 12. Finally, we print out the number of steps and rotations. Quadrature encoders have two objectives. In addition to keeping track of the number of rotations, it also tracks the direction the encoder is rotating. This rotation is defined by 16 steps. Steps are still transitions from unbroken, which is a 1, to broken, which is a 0. Track A is the inner track, and track B is the outer track. If track A is going from unbroken to broken, and B is broken, then we know we're moving counterclockwise. If B is unbroken, then we know that we're going clockwise. Conversely, if track A goes from broken to unbroken, and track B is still broken, we are moving clockwise. And if B is unbroken, then we're moving counterclockwise. In our code, we need to know the current state of the sensor reading on track A and compare it to the previous state. If we see a state change on track A, then we need to look at track B in order to determine the direction. The state change on track A also needs to increment the number of steps. The step count should increase for a clockwise turn and decrease for a counterclockwise turn. And finally, we need to calculate the number of rotations and print the values. The three global constants are the pins for the two tracks and the number of steps per rotation. We define integer values for the current and past states of track A, the current state of track B, and the number of steps. Since our rotation could be negative or positive, the rotations variable is a float. In our code, we're going to divide the number of steps by the number of steps per rotation. This could give us a non-integer value, meaning it could be a decimal number. This is why we have to use a float instead of an integer. In the void setup, we start serial communication, and then we set the digital pins as inputs since they are sensors, and we turn on the pull-up resistor for each pin. In the void loop, we first read the state of each sensor. Then we want to compare state changes. Unlike the incremental encoder, we can't just look for any change. We need to know if the A track has changed from a 0 to a 1, or 1 to a 0. We need to introduce another Boolean operator, the double ampersand. This means AND. This statement says if the current state is equal to 1 and the last state is equal to 0, then we can enter the if statement. If either of these are false, then we skip the if statement and move on to the next section. Inside of the if statement, we need the program to perform another comparison in order to determine the direction. If the current state of B is equal to 0, then we know the encoder is turning counterclockwise and we want to take 1 away from the step count. If the B track isn't equal to 0, we don't want it to just exit the if statement. If B is equal to 1, then we know it's moving clockwise, and to fix this, we add an else statement. We are basically saying if B is equal to 0, then take 1 step away, else you can add 1. Track A could also transition from a 0 to a 1, so we need to add a similar nested if statement for that case. Again, we're going to compare the current to the previous states. This time, if B is equal to 1, we are spinning counterclockwise, and if it's equal to 0, we are moving clockwise. Once we are outside of these if statements, we can set the last state for track A to the current one. We divide the number of track steps by the number of steps per rotation, and we get a value for the number of rotations we've accomplished. This time we can see fractions for rotations, and the more steps we have on our encoder, the finer movements we can track. Then we need to print these values out through the serial monitor. With the absolute encoder, we aren't tracking the number of rotations, we're just looking at the angle that the motor is currently at. The encoder is split into 8 sections. These sections divide up the 360-degree range of the wheel. The unbroken is still a 1, and the broken is still a 0. To determine the location, we need to know what the 3-bit code for each section of our encoder is, and the corresponding degree range. We'll need to read all of the sensors, store the values in an array, and then compare these values to the bit codes that we have for each of the sections. And then we can print out these values. Since we have 3 sensors, we're going to use arrays. We also used arrays in our sundial video. We said arrays were akin to waiters using trays to carry food. Programs use it to store and carry variables. We have constant arrays containing the pin values for the sensors, and inside of the curly brackets, we're going to put the pin numbers. We need to track the current state of each of the sensors, and we initialize each of them to 0. In the void setup, we start serial communication. Then we write a for loop to set each of the pins as an input, and we turn on their internal pull-up resistors. For this for loop, we will go through 3 iterations. Sensor pin at position 0 is equal to pin 5, position 1 is equal to pin 6, and position 2 is equal to pin 7. At the start of the void loop, we want to read the state of each of the sensors. We'll use a similar for loop that will check the state of each pin and then store it into the states array. We need to write a series of else if statements, and then we're going to use the double ampersand Boolean operator that we just learned about. This time we're going to compare 3 values. If all 3 statements are true, then the program is going to print out that section's degree value. If they do not all match, then the program goes down to the next else if statement and checks that one. And it continues to do this all the way down the line. Today we learned about Boolean logic. If statements compare values. If they are true, we enter the if statement. If they are false, then we move on down the code. This symbol means not equal, and this one means that 2 or more statements have to be true. If there are 2 options in an if statement, we use if and else. If there are several, then we use else if. For more in-depth look at arrays and loops, check out our sundial video.
If you want to learn more about encoders, there's a playlist that shows you how they work and how to build one. If you have any questions or comments for us, you can leave them down below. You can get a hold of us on any of the social media platforms. If you want to support us, you can go to patreon.com/scijoy. And remember, keep exploring.